Hi everyone, welcome back. So in this video we will see how we can seed the data, how we can insert the data into our system. So what we will do is we'll just collect some data.json. You can get it from datagenerator.com. I think I have that link somewhere. So you can use that library to generate some data in your application, like this generatedata.com. So I created a user data having name, email, password and address. So what we will do is now we will use this data only to insert data in our system. So you can see authenticate is done, then sync. After that, we are able to start our server. Then what we will do, we will use the bulk create utility to create the users in one go. So we will need to create 100 users in a system. What we will do, first we need to collect the data, which is a JSON format. It should look like this. In the data, you will have all the, it is an array of all the objects of name, email, password, and address. We have updated our schema model. Now we are not using, we are using ID as an auto-incremented primary key. User, email, password, and address is there. And there is a post schema model, title and description. And there is a relationship already defined. User has one post, okay? After that, in the dot, then what we can do, we can just call the user dot bulk create utility, and bulk create is taking the data. Data is nothing but it is having array of all the users. So when you do the bulk create, it will insert all the data. And here you always do the exception handling of all these things if error has occurred. For now, we'll just do console.log error. Right, so let's run this. So you can see it has executed this. It has created the users, a lot of users in the system. You can see a lot of users has been created. It's around 100, right? And the post also has an entry in the system, because once user has been created, what we are doing, we are actually creating the post also, post.create. So it has also the same utility, post.insert or update hook, max, main, name, remove attribute, all these hooks are available. And after that, we have all these methods, insert or update, insert, create, bulk create, all these are the utility methods we have in the system. So we are just executing create to create a post for the user ID 1. So it has a one-to-one relationship where user ID is a foreign key in the post collection, right? So this is the beauty of Sequelize, and we will keep learning how we are associating the two MySQL tables using has one relationship in the system. So whenever you run this, actually all the seeders are running, it is inserting the database and then inserted to users, this complete data is being inserted. Okay, in the next video we'll take a look more about the Sequelize documentation, how we can create hooks, how we can do the data validations, and we will expose this data of user tables from some API.